When the Other Side continues.
We need this combined mind, this combined effort, really to form the medicine of the future.
Please welcome the Associate Clinical Professor of Medicine at UCLA, Dr. Gail Randall. Thank you for joining us, Doc. What kinds of therapy were you using with Dr. Hanley here when she got sick?
Well, because Dr. Hanley is a healer and very well known, she was receiving many types of alternative therapies from associations that she has, oriental medicine, herbal therapy, many others, therapeutic touch. What I specifically provided for Dr. Hanley was a sort of unique combination of Western medicine, highly technical diagnosis and therapies, pharmaceuticals, and spiritual healing, that we really worked on a very personal level from more of a Native American standpoint.
When the methods available to you, traditional methods, have run their course, is that what leads physicians to explore additional or complementary strategies?
Yeah. Exactly. That's what led me to search out alternatives and find more tools to help my patients and myself.
Because that's, and we've heard this before, that's a very important distinction to make. It's not, you're not talking about doing something instead of medicine. You're talking about adding on or increasing strategies to what you were taught in medical school. Is that correct?
That's certainly my strategy and my guiding light.
Can you tell when you should use a traditional strategy versus a complementary or alternative strategy?
Well, traditional to me is Western medicine, because I was trained in Western medicine. But traditional to an Oriental physician would be Oriental medicine.
Mm-hmm.
But do I use Western medicine and recommend it? Absolutely. But to me, it's not really an issue of should I use Western medicine or should I use alternative medicine? And maybe alternative is not a good word. The power, the real power, comes in the combination. And what we need to do is work together. We need this combined mind, this combined effort, really to form the medicine of the future. And we're currently under the doing the type of work where we're trying to write that software.
Yes.
So our computers can talk to each other.
Yes.
So we can all work together, because mm-hmm. it really is one mind. Like Burton said, there's a lot of ways to get to the same spot.
Because we draw a rigid line. This is medicine, this is not medicine. And yet people are saying, yeah, but I was healed over here.
When I first found that I ran out of tools to help my patients with, I sought out other practitioners, such as doctors of Oriental medicine, and began working with them. And through that, I'm lucky enough to say I have a number of teachers in this area as well. So it was primarily through my patients not getting better and running out of tools to help them with that I sought out other teachers and practitioners to help me.
Are people with this kind of gift, and again, we've heard others, are they being studied?
Well, we did some very preliminary work at UCLA where we took patients that we had, where we'd really reached a dead end in terms of what we could offer them with Western medicine. And we had them see three types of healers. We had an Ayurvedic or Eastern Indian healer, a Native American practitioner, and a doctor of Oriental medicine. And the results were really fascinating. We found that these people that were at a dead end could be taken farther by adding these alternative measures. And it wasn't just herbal. I mean, part of the problem with Western medicine is not that it's not powerful, it's not that it's not good, but it doesn't address the spirit. It addresses the body.